Hey guys, my name is Matt Johnson, and today I want to show you three of the best pre-built 4K video editing PCs that you can buy for less than $1,000. Now, if you're on a budget, I would actually not buy any of these PCs, and instead I would recommend that you build your own. It's not hard to do. I've made videos showing you the exact parts to buy, as well as another video walking you through the entire process for building a video editing computer. My latest build guide will show you how to build a budget video editing PC for $650, which is by far the best value for your dollar, in my opinion. That video is linked down in the video description. But if not, maybe you don't have time to build. Maybe you want guaranteed tech support if something breaks. I get it. So in that case, let's look at some pre-built 4K video editing PCs for under $1,000. Up first, in order from cheapest to most expensive, we have a desktop from CyberPower PC that currently retails for $749 from Best Buy. With a 6-core Ryzen 5 3600 and a Radeon RX 580 graphics card, this is going to work well for budget 4K video editing in Adobe Premiere Pro and DaVinci Resolve, as well as be good for After Effects, music production, live streaming on Twitch, and yes, even gaming. Please be aware though, that at this price, this computer only comes with 8 GB of RAM, and I would recommend for 4K video editing that you at least get 16 GB. Thankfully, RAM is one of the easiest parts to install in a computer. Simply pop out the old sticks and pop in the new and you're good. I will include a link down in the description to RAM that I would recommend that you purchase for this PC, as well as a link to a video showing you how to install this RAM. There will also be links to all of the pre-built computers that I've talked about, as well as any accessories that I recommend for them down in the video description next to the like button. Next up, we're taking a jump in price, but also a nice jump in power. This is the HP Pavilion TG01, and you can customize it to include a Ryzen 7 3700X 8-core processor and an NVIDIA GTX 1650 for a reasonable $900 in my time of pricing it. This processor is going to be a significant upgrade in speed over the processor in the previous computer. Keep in mind though, that $900 price includes switching the hard drive to a 256 GB SSD, which is a necessity in 2020. I would also still highly recommend upgrading the RAM to 16 GB. But I have good news. When customizing the system on HP's site, you can opt to include 16 GB of RAM for $110 more. While you're at it, this is completely optional, but if you have the budget, I would also recommend selecting the NVIDIA 1660 graphics card as an upgrade. The 6 GB of video memory in that card will come in handy when editing 4K video. Lastly, I would go for the $10 upgrade to the 400-watt power supply to make sure this PC has enough power. With the upgraded RAM, which is mandatory in my opinion, as well as the optional upgraded graphics card and power supply, this computer is now coming in at $1,170, which is above the $1,000 budget for these builds. With that in mind, let's look at one more PC that is cheaper than $1,000 and most importantly, won't require you to open it up to install RAM like option number one and won't go over $1,000 like option number two. Video editing PC number three is this, the CyberPower PC Gamer Master Gaming Desktop. Don't be thrown off by the amount of times that gaming is thrown at you in this computer's title. There is a very large overlap between gaming and video editing whenever you're looking at a PC's power. This computer has an AMD Ryzen 5 3600 CPU, a Radeon RX 5600 XT graphics card, and 16 GB of RAM, meaning that you shouldn't need to open it up at all. Also, at the time of this video, it retails for $950, easily coming in under the $1,000 budget. So which one should you buy? Do you go for the $750 CyberPower PC from Best Buy that needs a RAM upgrade? The $900 PC from HP with easily upgradable power? Or the $950 CyberPower PC that doesn't require you to open it up at all? I already said, I think you should build your own and save some money. But if I had to choose, I would go with the $750 option and upgrade the RAM easily myself. Lastly, if you are wanting to buy a pre-built video editing PC, I think that you should know that almost as important as what you are buying is when you buy it. There are many stores that you can buy a PC from these days. Amazon, Newegg, Best Buy, B&H. Many of these stores often have sales that offer steep discounts. So if you don't need to purchase a computer right away, waiting until a major holiday or sale, Black Friday, Cyber Monday, 4th of July, Amazon Prime Day, World Beard Day, if you can think of a holiday, there's probably a sale going on somewhere and you can most likely get a substantial discount. In fact, the first CyberPower PC I recommended in this video that is currently $750 was marked down to $600 on Black Friday. such a good deal. With all that in mind, considering that prices are constantly fluctuating and things go in and out of stock all the time, if one of these three PCs that I've recommended goes out of stock, please leave me a comment down below and let me know, and I'll replace it with a roughly equivalent option for hopefully roughly the same price. I'm sure some of you are thinking, Matt, there's still a lot that we need to talk about. What about mice, keyboards, speakers, monitors? Don't worry, I have you covered. Linked down in the description are all of the physical accessories that I would recommend that you purchase. I realize that everybody has a different opinion, but this is just what I would recommend. With that, I hope this video has been helpful to you with picking out a budget pre-built 4K video editing PC. Also, do you want to see more video editing computer buying guides like this? Leave me a comment down below and let me know. Lastly, it would be a huge help to me if you would consider liking this video, subscribing, and consider joining my filmmaking Facebook group, linked down in the video description as well. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.